Hey, Steve Ramsden here from DIY Movie Making, and this week I'm going to show you how to easily swing on a web like Spider-Man. Today's video is sponsored by our friends at Production Crate, a fantastic all-in-one assets hub for your filmmaking. Spider-Man is always fun, and as it's been a while since my last superhero video, I thought it was time to have a go at swinging on a web like Peter Parker. Today I'm going to show you how you can make your own Spider-Man web-swinging VFX shot just using Adobe After Effects. I'm always trying to do a lot with a little and make great effects shots on a serious budget. And if you want to see lots more fun DIY movie making tips and tricks, then hit that subscribe button. So I deliberately went out and filmed this effect totally solo, to prove that you can do all of this on your own. As a quick disclaimer though, in my opinion this effect is always going to look pretty cartoony by its very nature, so just bear this in mind if you're going to attempt it. The first thing I was looking for was something the web could swing from, and I used this telegraph pole in a quiet location, but you could use the corner of a building or anything else convenient. Now you only really need to film one shot for this effect. This is a wide shot with the object you're going to be swinging from right in the middle, and I would suggest that you deliberately keep your phone or camera quite far off while filming this so that you won't have many perspective problems when coming to do the edit. So my shot has the pole in the middle of the frame and enough room on both sides to film me firing the web and starting to swing from one side, and then, because I figure I'm just a trainee Spider-Man, it goes wrong and detaches and then I fall to the ground on the other side. For this shot I set the camera rolling, ran over to one side of the pole and acted the first half of the shot, firing the web at the top of the pole and jumping as if I was being pulled into the air by the web. Then I quickly moved to the other side of the pole, and then jumped and landed on the ground as if I had fallen off the web. And the reason I did all this quite quickly was in case the clouds or light changed a lot between these two bits of action. While you're rolling, it's also a good idea to get a few seconds of what's called a clean plate, meaning the same shot but without you in it at all. This can come in handy later on, and that's all you really need to film. To make the finished result a little better though, I tried filming a few other shots to put at the start and the end. I filmed me pretending to react to somebody calling for help in the distance, and then firing the web up at the pole, and then landing on the other side of the pole after my web slinging has gone wrong. And then that was everything filmed, and it was time to try and put it together. Now for the editing part of this tutorial, as usual I'm just going to give a quick overview, but if you want to learn every single process I am using from scratch in full detail, you can of course check out my After Effects Essentials course, and the link to learn more about that is below. So first I opened the master shot in a new composition inside After Effects. I duplicated it and named one start and one end. I cut down the start clip to end at the moment when I am jumping and I am in a good position in the air. Then I did the same with the end clip and cut off everything except me landing. So now we have a start and an end, and we need to create the part where I am swinging in the air to hide the join. So to begin building this, I duplicated the start layer again and renamed it Figure Freeze Frame. I trimmed it down to that single frame where I am in the middle of my jump, and then right-clicked on it, went to Time and Freeze Frame. Now this layer is frozen, and next you can use the Pen tool to draw a mask around your figure, and you can soften the mask edge a little bit if you want, using Mask Feather. Once this is done, now we are going to change its movement using keyframes on the position and rotation controls to make it look like it is being pulled by the web. Click on the stopwatch icon by the position control, drop one keyframe where the figure starts, and then another one a few moments later, and then move the figure cutout up into the sky diagonally. So at some point around here we need to build our spider web, and for this you can either build it yourself manually in After Effects or Photoshop, or you can use a pre-keyed VFX element. So rather than spending a long time building this, I headed over to our sponsor Production Crate, where they have an amazing library of elements that you can use in your own films. You'll have seen their effects used in some of our previous videos, and they are such a useful production resource for us with our DIY movie making effects videos. They have a huge amount of pre-keyed visual effects assets, as well as sound effects and music, and it's all under one affordable subscription, and they also provide a lot of free options as well if you just want to create a basic account with them. And if you sign up using our link below this video, they will know we sent you, and it helps us out a little bit too. So in Production Create, there is a section called Magic Powers, and inside there is this webbing effects section, which has a ton of really fun Spider-Man style web elements already created from every possible angle. So all you need to do is pick the one that matches the angle of your shot the best, download it, and add it into your scene. For my master shot, this was one of the widest angles, so I made a start by downloading one of these. They are already pre-keyed, meaning you don't need to remove the background. So I could just import my web element, make sure the frame rate matched my own, and then dropped this in over my shot. Now, because the web is white and it was a bright sunny day when I filmed this, the web is a little hard to see, so if you right click and create a new solid in a dark color and put this layer under the web and then turn the opacity low, you will find it easier to see the web while you edit. So first, on the web layer, I realigned the anchor point, which is shown as this little green circle, so that it lines up with the top of the web, as this is the point where I want to rotate around. And then I shuffled the position controls until the web was over the top of the pole. Then, using the rotation control, I could line up the web with my arm and keyframe this to match those small movements during the moment when I am firing the web just before I jump. On the Production Create element, the web not only flies out, but it also flies back in, and I wanted this web to last a little bit longer before it disappears. So to extend just the middle section when the web is out, you can right-click on the web layer and go to Time and enable Time Remapping. Then if you set two keyframes on each end of the area to extend, just pick up that second one and drag it to the point you need. This will slow down the time while the web is out, and it won't affect the part where the web flies back in. Now I could parent the figure layer to the web layer, and this means that wherever the web moves, the figure will now move too. So now you can keyframe the rotation of the web so that the figure ends up on the other side around the point where the figure will land. You have to look heavy enough, you have to look like you take long enough to do the swing, and you really just need to do some trial and error shifting the keyframes around until it looks pretty good. During this moment where the swing happens, you'll probably need to create an empty background behind the figure to fill the gap between the start shot and the ending shot. Now you might want to use your clean plate image for this, or if you want to keep using the same shot, maybe due to the clouds changing, you can just paste part of that clean plate shot over the moment where you ran to the other side. You can now draw a mask to cut off the extra part of the web you don't need, and turn on the motion blur toggle on the web and the figure layers to make the quick movements look more natural. So now we have a basic figure swinging, but this doesn't look that great as it's pretty obviously a freeze frame that doesn't move, and we also need to find a way to turn this figure into the one that actually lands on the ground. So if you're going for extra realism and you want to improve things a little, you can do this by duplicating your end layer and extending it backwards, and using the pen tool to cut out some of your real jump as a separate mask. Then once again you can parent it to the web layer, just like the freeze frame layer that you're currently using. Then you can find a moment to disguise the join, where you stop using the freeze frame layer and start using your real jump from the end. I actually used the moment where the figure swings past the pole, and guess what, you're left with exactly the right figure to land on the ground. But if you want to keep things simple and just use the freeze frame layer for the whole swing, another good trick is to animate this figure with the puppet pin tool. This lets you click on various points and then animate them over time, just like a puppet. So using a combination of these methods, I made it look like the figure was moving while in the air, and I think this is the most important thing to sell the idea to the audience that they are looking at the real person flying through the air and not just a frozen cutout. Then I added another color solid with a mask on it as a little shadow, which I keyframed over time. I also had fun using my real shadow on the telegraph pole from when I had run past it, so I chopped this out and used this too. I always say if you have it recorded for real, then use the real thing. The top of the spider web just rotating looked incorrect, as it should be sticking to the pole. Now you can of course crop this out, but I thought it would be fun to again animate this using the puppet pin tool, so that the top of the web stays where it is and the bottom moves. And then it looks like I stretched the web too far and this is why it broke. Finally, to make the shot more interesting with some camera movement, I highlighted all the layers at once, right-clicked, and pre-composed everything into a new composition, which just means everything can now be treated as one layer in a new timeline. Then I could use the position and scale keyframes to zoom in and add some camera movement, which follows the action as the figure swings across the frame. Finally, adding an adjustment layer allowed me to do some color grading to the whole shot using Lumetri Color. So that was everything complete on the master shot, and then for my additional close-up shot of shooting the web, I went back to Production Crate and once again found the perfect angle of web to use. For this shot, I got a better match for my scene's colours by toggling on the blending modes and changing the mode for the web layer to screen instead of normal, and changing these blending modes can often really help with compositing pre-made VFX elements like this. Lastly, for my sound design, Production Crate even had the perfect web-firing sound effects on the same page, and these were really fun to try and time with the shots. So with that, I was done, and it was time to look back at the finished effect.
I'll be there in a minute.
If you are a video creator who wants to try making VFX but have no idea where to start, or if you're just interested in how I plan and shoot my visual effects shots, then you will love my free 40-minute webinar, which is the first link in the video description below. I share my 7 steps to planning and filming fun VFX shots, and I also walk you through what Adobe After Effects can do and why I use it for most of my compositing work. And I also give you a look at what is inside my After Effects Essentials course, in which I teach a complete beginner how to use the program to get results like I do in my VFX work. There's a downloadable selection of my footage for my students to practice with and follow along with me, and they are getting some great results. So check out the link below if you want to learn more or join the course and the private community. And until next time, happy movie making.